good looking woman, eh? So you think not a good looking woman like me would have a good looking man? Well, nothing. Melvin was as ugly as a cow pad. But he did have a deadly mouth organ. You know, some people can pick up a musical instrument, play a song straight out. But Melvin wasn't one of those people. He had two notes. In and out.
Now, when I was a young heifer, I didn't really care for men. I was happy just doing my job. I'd have my soap, I'd be scrubbing and wringing, and Melvin would be copying me on his blinking mouth organ. In and out. So, I started off slow, then a little bit faster, and faster and faster and faster and faster, and he kept playing faster and faster, and I thought I could outscrub him, and he thought he could outblow me. And I got wilder and wilder, and he got puffier and puffier, and then that's it. I chucked the soap at him and knocked the hat clean off his head. I been just fall in love with him then and there, because underneath that big hat was a bald head. And a bald head can do strange things to a woman. But he weren't interested in me.
I'm a green skin. No woman gonna brand me.
No matter. My branding iron was at Auntie Darbella's camp. She had all the love songs. But she didn't think too much of Malvern.
Oh girl, you don't need a love song. You need something for your eyes. He proper ugly.
But Auntie, he's proper handsome from his eyeballs up.
Anyway, you're too late. Sally already been here for some.
Sally? You stealing bugger!
What are you busting yourself for, Nene? I'm the one who should be angry. I know you've been trying to tell my man. I see you polishing his head. In, out, in, out. Well, you can save your polishing for the cure then, because he's my man, not yours. Anyway, there's a lot of other men going around here. Like, women. He's alright from back here, when the sun's going down and he's not crouching.
Now you listen here, Sally. Just because you've been sneaking Melvin Tucker, don't make him yours. Now, we're just gonna have to have a bignotti hit for hit.
Just as I was lining up to knock Sally's gum bones down her big mouth, the missus came running up with her Bible.
Girls, 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 I don't want any fighting on the station. Now the good book tells us what we should do. Here we go. We should cut Melvin in half, and you can have half each.
Well, we were both standing there with our mouths open when Sally said,
I don't want the bottom half. Maybe you can have his head.
No, I don't want Melvin cut off. So, Sally, you can have him.
Well, Maymay, I think that you truly love Melvin and that you should have him.
Suddenly, one man looked pretty good to Sally.
One man, you want a cup of tea?
After Melvin found out about me and Sally fighting over him, he thought he was the world's greatest lover. But he was more like his mouth organ.
Now that I had my brand on Malvern, things were going well for us. The boss made him head stockman. The missus made Sally head of the household. And Malvern made me pregnant.
That you got in your tucker bag, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.